Now, call me crazy, but where I'm from, football means something else. So, as far as I understand, foot is the lower part of your body, and a ball is something like this. And this is what we play football with where I'm from. But it seems that there is another game around here where they use something called a pigskin. What the heck? Unless you have been living under a rock, I'm pretty sure you know something about a game called Blood Bowl. And one of my friends said, hey, I have a team, do you want to paint them? And I say, sure, why not? So he sent me these miniatures and I was expecting something like orcs or humans or something like that. But they are not anything close to that. So he has a team that he wants me to paint. And I'm gonna try to do this as fast as possible and I'm gonna teach you how to get the same results that I do. So keep up with me. So today I have these ladies that seems that they play football or, well, you know, that sport. And I'm gonna start to paint them for my friend. My first step today is Raglan Nightshade. No, Raglan Fleshshade. Now I'm gonna give them a coat of this on those parts that are exposed. So in this case we have the legs and the face and the arms. I'm starting with the skin because it's the lower part of the miniature, and you, when you paint with washes, you should aim at painting the deep crevices first. That way you will stain them and you won't have to worry about them getting stained from the secondary coat. We should have on this first coat of flesh, and I'm gonna repeat that with all the miniatures of the team. I'm gonna start painting the clothes and I'm gonna use Gilliman blue. My friend said that he wanted a bluish color scheme for the Valkyries, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. This blue, I'm gonna put it in the clothes that they have, but not this side here. I'm gonna do something else to that. These are nice miniatures. And they are tremendously easy to paint with this technique. Because they are small and they don't have too many details. So you can have this team ready in a couple of sessions. That's the beauty of using washes. You don't have to work much for good results. It's basically cheating. This is how the miniature looks with only one coat of blue. This is how they look with two coats of blue. As you can see, there is a more pale nuance to this one, and this one is darker and richer. And this is what I've done with all the miniatures but this one. So in order to achieve this tunic, I use Gilliman blue twice. So next step now. So the step with the blue is done, and the next one that I'm gonna do is Drakenhop Nightshade. So I want to make this cloth look like white, but if you let it be like completely white, it's not gonna look right. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put some of it just in the crevices, nowhere else. And that's exactly how we're gonna achieve that grayish color. So this is shading. And you have to be a little bit more careful than normal with the technique of using washes, but it's gonna pay off. I'm also putting the wash inside of the small skirt right here, because I'm going to darken that later, so it looks like there is some shading as well. And another thing that I'm doing is putting it on the wings on top of the head. Alright, so all the gray parts are painted, and the next step I'm gonna do is Gehenna's Gold. And what I'm going to do is paint the shoulder pads on all the Valkyries with this paint. I think gold is going to be a great color for them because it looks bright, and at the same time it's yellow, kind of, and it's going to go great against blue. So it's gonna make a nice contrast. The reason why I'm doing this at this moment is because I want to paint the leather, and leather is going to use some brown ink. So gold, in order to enrich it, I'm gonna use also those brown inks on it. Besides the shoulder pads, I'm gonna also paint the belt, and I'm going to do another gold color. Later on, I will paint some stuff on it, but as of now, it's only gold paint on the shoulder plates and the belt. This creates a nice contrast because, as you can see, it makes a triangle figure. That's what we're gonna do. 11 of these girls, and next step after this. And once again, I welcome thee to the world of Seraphine Sepia, the most awesome wash there is. Yeah, I know, I have a fetish with this thing. Well, whatever. I'm gonna use this thing to shade all the armor. We're gonna do a wash of this on the corset and also the avant braces. I don't know. Those things. And also the boots. Yep, right there. And it has taken me like what? 40 minutes maybe to get to this step. So yeah, washes. That's why you watch this channel, because you want to learn how to paint fast. Like moi. And also the gold. Carefully now. We'll give it volume and more realism. Alright, there we are. So this is to be repeated with all the 11 miniatures. Avant braces, the chest piece, the shoulder pads, the belt and the boots. And yep, let's do that. Now, in order to save time, I'm going to go straight to Cassandra Yellow. These are Nordic mythology creatures, and therefore I think that blonde hair is probably the best option. So what I'm going to do is paint all their hair yellow, and with subsequent washes I will try to achieve a more natural color. Alright, that will be the first one. 10 more to go. So for the next step, I'm going to use flesh wash. Now, you know from previous videos, these washes are not made anymore. But I've been doing some research because, you know, eventually I'm gonna run out of them. And I found a store that carries a similar thing from a different brand altogether. And I'm gonna put that on the link description. On the description below. I'm going to use this wash on the leather to make it a little bit more dark and richer. But also, so you see what I'm going to do later, I'm gonna water it down, okay, and I'm gonna use it in the hair, thus creating a more effective shading on the hair. On this step, I'm gonna focus only on three of the miniatures because they have some details that I want to work with, and I already gave them a coat of blood leather in the inside of the capes and the ball, and now I'm gonna proceed to the second part of this. So for the ball, I'm going to use Fuego Orange and give it that distinctive orangish hue that most footballs have. Being careful not to stain the fingers or anything else, but the ball itself. That's it. And for the capes, I'm going to use my other combination with red that I like a lot, is Caribou Crimson. I was thinking about giving them a too thick coat of blood leather, but I thought that it will be a nice contrast to get this burgundy. Burgundy is a nice color, and I think it goes well with the more regal appearance of these particular miniatures. If you stain something, and you're bound to do such mistakes, what you have to do is just get water real fast and spread that wash and then more water and just get rid of it. Here I'm going to let dry on this step flat so the wash doesn't accumulate at the bottom and just goes into the crevices. Just like that. Next step. On this next step, I'm going to focus only on these two miniatures and I'm going to use Agrax Earthshade. I want to try something different and see what happens. So I'm just going to go ahead and put Agrax, pure Agrax, on top of the white undercoat. The first video you watch on this channel, remember that I never ever water down the washes whenever I'm doing coats like this one. And just like before, after you do this, leave your miniatures to dry flat, just like that, so you get wash, you know, covering everything and not going down to the bottom. So next step while I finish this. So next step now, while these guys or these gals dry out, I'm gonna do brown ink. Brown ink, it's a great wash that you can use for metal, basically gold, okay? And I think this gold needs an extra oomph. So this is going to give it a shiny wash on top of it, and also it's gonna make it look darker. That is not a problem as of now, because it's exactly what I want. I want it to look a little bit darker, like older, more ancient. But later on, I'm going to highlight it. Now, I don't want it too dark, so I'm watering it down, and I also will remove any excess and pass it to another miniature. You can also use this wash as one of the finishing steps, because sometimes you will notice that there are like small gaps with white primer that you don't want them to be there. And you can use this as a shading, last minute shading to those places. So I'll be doing this. And then we're gonna do the next step. Just a little bit on these crevices, no more. That's it. We are getting there, almost done. There is not much left to be done, but these are the most important steps, because these are going to create the feeling that the miniatures are really well painted or not. So what I'm using here is Druchy Violet. I'm gonna use that sparingly on the eyes. So I'm getting my fine detail brush. I'm just putting a couple of those drops on the eyes. With the eyes, I'm going to use chestnut ink. And this, I'm just gonna put it on the lips. I think a little bit of lipstick is going to improve that female look. Once again, I'm using a detail brush and just putting a little bit of it on the lips. That's it, you don't need that much to change the appearance of the face. I'm gonna start painting the gems. I'm going to use these three colors in layers. I'm going to paint them red because I think that's one of the colors that they lack the most in this miniature. So this is the technique. You paint one of the lower corners with the first basic color, just leaving a little bit of black on the top opposite side. Repeat the process with all the gems, making sure all of them have the same paint on the same place. I'll be repeating this same thing with all 11 of them, and then we get to the next step on the gems. Next step on the gems, we're gonna repeat the same process with a clearer color. In this case will be this red. So now, really careful, again you have to leave the black corner and a little bit of the previous red, so you get some layering. next step. Now you can use pink or orange, it's up to you. Same thing, be careful. Go to the lower corner and leave a little bit of the two previous colors. This is really subtle now. Now that the gems have been basically painted, I'm going to the white scar. I waited this long to do this because I wanted to use white only in one step. There are several things that need to be done with this color now. One of them is highlighting the wings on the head. And for that, I'm just going to paint these feathers like this and right no there. More. I like the gray that they got, but I think they need a little bit more volume. So I'm just going to paint these places, no more. After that, I'm going to do some highlights on this small piece of fabric, because sometimes you put too much wash on it and I just need the crevices to be shaded. So I'm just going to do that and fix some of the previous mistakes with this. Also, what I'm going to do is now these fine details here, the eyes, and you need some good pulls there. So we're gonna leave that purple around this white. So I'm gonna be repeating this step with all the miniatures, and we are ready almost to finish them. Another thing that needs to be done, and this is now, is finishing the gems. You need to put a dot of pure white on that corner that you left up where it's only black, and then you got to put another dot or a small line if you are capable of doing it on the orange part at the bottom. That is what gives it tridimensional appearance to the gems. Show you with another miniature. Okay, this one for instance. So dot, dot, not a dot there. Another dot there. And here. Highlights. Highlights on the wings. Don't give up on your miniatures halfway. You have a lot to do and you can fix all your problems almost basically at the end when you're doing the fine details. So if you made any mistakes before, don't worry about them until the very end. Just continue, do it step by step, be patient and finish them off and get them looking the way you want them to look. And now, the most difficult part here, in my opinion, is the eyes. So with nicely watered down paint, not too much, not too little, paint that small line there. There you go. Let's get to the other 10 and we'll be done. And now I'm gonna highlight the metals. So the first step, I'm gonna get back to Johannes Gold and make sure that the surfaces look clean and a little bit new. So we had that previous wash and now I'm trying to regain some of the color and just leave the shade that the wash has created. We're almost there, only a couple more steps and the miniatures will be finished and ready for B-base. Now that's something I'm not gonna do, my friend. I have no idea what he wants to do with them, so I leave that to him, and he has a great skill in doing bases, so I guess he's gonna do an awesome job on these ones as well. This is what we should get on the shoulder pad, a nice clean gold with some shading there, and I'm going to proceed to do the same in the jewels. Now here I have to be really careful. for the final highlights on the metals, I'm going to use runefang steel. You do not have to overdo it. You have to be careful and just stick to the sides and, you know, highlight only those. I'm still using my fine detail brush here. These miniatures are kind of small compared to other types of miniatures that I paint, namely the orcs, and therefore the brush has to be quite sharp to do this job. So I'm gonna repeat this with all of them, and then we're gonna do the last step of the painting process. It is time for the final step on painting the miniatures, and we're gonna use Ebony Black. And this is one of the things that can make or break a miniature. And if you're not really confident about it, you should practice before in order to do it right. What I'm going to do is paint the eyes, okay? The pupil. Now the faces are a focal point and the eyes are tremendously important for you to create the right impression on your miniatures. So as I said, if you are not confident about what you're gonna do, make sure that you practice a little bit. I also use this step to fix any mistakes that I might see in the eyes. These miniatures have really small eyes and painting them is difficult, not gonna lie, so we should be really careful at this moment. The consistency of the paint has to be close to ink, so you can just leave a small dot. Do not drink coffee before doing this. Was difficult. Now, some pictures.